These trucks are used on the flight line, the runway. They all deal with the aircraft.
The water seen discharging is a view of the foam testing system in operation. Engineers are demonstrating how the environmentally safe process uses water to test the foam proportioning system on Air Force Fire Emergency Service aircraft rescue firefighting vehicles.
What this is measuring is the amount of foam that would be going through there, but we're just using water.
The use of water only in the foam testing system is one example of the Air Force taking voluntary aggressive measures to eliminate potential contamination of drinking water sources from two perfluorinated compounds, perfluorooctane sulfonic acid and perfluorooctanoic acid, or PFOS and PFOA for short. Both PFOS and PFOA are commonly used in many industrial and consumer products, like aqueous film-forming foam used by commercial industries and the armed services to extinguish petroleum fuel fires. The Air Force Civil Engineer Center is leading the Air Force's effort to retrofit the fleet of more than 900 aircraft rescue firefighting, or ARF, vehicles. Per policy, firefighters must test the system on ARF vehicles annually to ensure operational accuracy.
What this allows them to do is test those percentages without actually discharging foam, whereas in the past they would have to discharge foam.
The ARF fleet at Tyndall Air Force Base, Florida, was the first to be retrofitted with a new testing system in late 2016. The team's goal is to have the retrofits complete Air Force-wide by fall 2018.
It allows people in the communities to feel safer.
This is going to be a great thing for the Air Force.
Reporting for the Air Force Civil Engineer Center, I'm Brian Godden.